with the Master for this 31st day of May, 2021. I am Father Josh, the Egg Friar, pastor of St. Martin's Celtic Catholic Church in Concord, North Carolina. Still coming to you from Kuwait, but this is the last day of May, so I have 13 Sundays left. So our readings for this week, Holy Trinity Sunday, or this past Sunday, were Deuteronomy chapter 4, verses 32 through 40, Psalm 33, verses 2 through 9, Romans 8, verses 14 through 17, and Matthew 28, verses 16 through 20. As always, we encourage you to read these all, but I am going to focus on the epistle today, which is the passage from Romans. It's fun. I could preach a sermon on each of those, and I could talk at length about the Trinity, but I will let people smarter than I do that. There's plenty of information on that. What I want to share with you is this epistle. It says, "All who are led by the Spirit of God are sons of God. For you did not receive the spirit of slavery to fall back into fear, but you have received the spirit of sonship. When we cry, Abba, Father, it is the Spirit Himself bearing witness with our spirit that we are children of God, and if children, then heirs, heirs to God and fellow heirs with Christ, provided we suffer with Him in order that we may also be glorified with Him." So, a couple of quick things here. This is going to be a shorter video, I think. But a couple of quick things here. First of all, you do see the Trinity in this, because it talks about being led by the Spirit of God. It is the Spirit that bears witness, and that we are heirs with God and fellow heirs with Christ. So you have Father, Son, and Holy Spirit represented in this one little passage. That, by the way, so the Trinity, I will say this, the Trinity is a unique feature of Orthodox Christianity, and it is one of the things that separates. There's a lot of cults who claim to be Christian, but who throw out the Trinity. That is a foundational doctrine for Christians, and if you don't accept it, then you are not a Christian. You're welcome to worship however you want. We live in America, but, I live in America, freedom of religion and all that good stuff, but don't call yourself Christian if you don't accept the Trinity. However, what I want to talk about, I love this idea of adoption. So it says, Paul says that we are, that we did not receive a spirit of slavery, but a spirit of sonship is what it says in this translation. We are adopted as children of God. All who are led by the Spirit of God are sons or children of God. Now first of all, let's just take that one thing. How are you a child of God if you are led by the Spirit of God? There's a lot of people who will say, well, we're all children of God. And in a sense, that's correct, because we are all created in God's image. I believe we all bear the mark of God in our spirit. But we are all born dead in our trespasses and sins, as Paul also says. And so it says, if you are led by the Spirit of God, the evidence of sonship, of adoption, the evidence of being a child of God is if you are led by the Spirit of God. So if there are, now it doesn't mean you won't ever do anything wrong, but what I would say it means is that the general trajectory of your life is toward what God commands, what God calls us to do. You are moving in that direction. And I would say that there are many, many, many people throughout the years, well, right now even, many people. In fact, Jesus actually says this, that there will be many who say, Lord, Lord, and he'll say, I never knew you, because they were not led by the Spirit of God. Therefore, they were not sons or children of God. So you got to be led. Now, that's a whole other sermon, but got to be led by the Spirit. I will say just this one thing. Being led by the Spirit of God has nothing to do with what you say you believe, and it has everything to do with what you do. If your actions are consistent with Christ, so you trust him in faith, but then your actions are consistent, as James says, faith without actions is dead, then you're being led by the Spirit of God. Anyway, we do not receive a spirit of slavery to fall back into fear, okay, but we receive a spirit of sonship. We are adopted, and we cry, Abba, Father. Abba is a word that Jesus used to refer to his Father. It demonstrates a familial relationship, not just that we are slaves in the house of God, but that we are truly children of God. It's why Jesus tells his disciples, I no longer call you servants, but I call you my brothers. I call you my family. And then it says it's the Spirit himself that bears witness with our spirit that we are children of God. And if children, then heirs of God and fellow heirs with Christ. So heirs to what? We are heirs to eternity. We are heirs. All that God has is ours if we are children of God. I think that's amazing. Do you realize what that means? That the eternal God of the universe is giving everything to us. I am more in tune, if you will, with this idea of adoption because two of my sisters have adopted children into their families. And those children, although they were not genetically born into their families, are every bit as much their children as if they had been. And so they will receive all the benefits of being a child of those families and all of the, when they die, all that they have will be theirs. That is what God says to us. And we're fellow heirs with Christ. Heirs in what? Well, here's the thing. Provided we suffer with him. And I preached on this a couple of weeks ago here in Kuwait, but, excuse me, we avoid, as Christians in America, we avoid suffering at all costs. It seems like when I go back and I read the writings of the early church fathers and early Christians, it seems like they almost sought out suffering. We seem to avoid suffering and do everything to mitigate suffering, but it says here, we will be heirs if we suffer with him, in order that we may be glorified with him. The ultimate gift, the ultimate benefit is that we will be glorified in the same way that Jesus was glorified. A risen and resurrected body, glorified and living in perfect harmony and relationship with the Trinity. But suffering is the doorway into that. Now, that does not mean necessarily that we have to bleed or be crucified or starve. I know, and I don't remember this, I'm gonna ask Brother Chris to speak to this just a bit, but I know that like in Celtic Christianity, there were various types of martyrdom that were, or suffering that were instituted because by that point in Christianity, there weren't as many people like dying for their faith as there were like in the early days of Christianity in the Roman Empire. But there are ways to suffer. When you, Jesus tells us, when you live the life of Christ, you will be rejected. That is suffering. When you are led by the Spirit of God, you will be persecuted. Not just by people outside the church, but by people who, they are outside the family of God, but people who sit in pews will persecute you because you're not doing it their way. You're not following the God that they have created out of their own preferences. That is suffering. There are various kinds of suffering. And James says, I just preached this a couple of weeks ago here in Kuwait, to count it all joy when we experience various trials and temptations, because these things lead to perfection, to a mature faith that allows us to be glorified with Christ. So, happy birthday. You are an heir of Christ as you are led by the Spirit of God and choose to walk in suffering with Him. So may the Lord bless you today. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.